What do AOC's Green New Deal, Bernie Sanders' climate justice, Beto's climate plan, and Jay Inslee's climate movement all have in common? They are different versions of failed European-style climate policies that have led to nothing more than higher taxes, bigger government, and resounding environmental disappointment. My name is Mandy Gunasekara. I'm the founder of Energy 45, which is a nonprofit focused on supporting President Trump's energy, environment, and economic successes through a range of strategic media engagements. Key pieces of each of their climate policies include getting back into the failed Paris Climate Accord. They also are premised on some value of carbon, either a carbon tax or a carbon fee. It mandates certain types of renewable energy, that the pace is changed not by market demands, but because of political preferences. Each of these policies presents a series of consequences that we've seen play out. Let's take Germany, for example. Germany has a policy in place they refer to as their energy transformation. It involves a series of mandates, taxes, and fees that they've spent $580 billion switching from fossil-based energy resources to wind and solar. Now they're at the point where they've spent billions of dollars, their emissions have not gone down in any meaningful way, and they're in desperate need of energy that they are building a pipeline to get natural gas from Russia. Then there's France. Last fall, France was scheduled to increase taxes on gas and diesel. This spurred the Yellow Vest riots, which France's working class citizens came to the streets to protest their more elite countrymen's climate ideology. Despite consistent failures, Democrats keep trying to sell these European-styled climate policies to the United States voters.
People are dying. They are dying. The world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change.
Today, we announced the New York City Green New Deal.
We're going to ban the classic glass and steel skyscrapers, which are incredibly inefficient.
The best approach is the one that President Donald Trump has imposed since day one, his energy dominance agenda, where he's fulfilled his promise to produce a robust economy based off of American energy at the same time that we continue to advance environmental progress.
Many of us remember the long gas lines and the constant claims that the world was running out of oil and natural gas. Americans were told that our nation could only solve this energy crisis by imposing draconian restrictions on energy production. But we now know that was all a big, beautiful myth. It was fake. My administration will seek not only the American energy independence that we've been looking for so long, but American energy dominance. And we're going to be an exporter.
So today, we are protecting the environment. Some could even say we are fighting climate change better than any other country in the entire world, under the direction and policies of President Donald Trump. So my final message to AOC, Beto, Bernie Sanders, and Governor Jay Inslee is that the United States has been successful because it's rejected the European-style climate policies that you were trying to impose. If you like this video, subscribe to The Daily Caller. And if you want to hear more about Energy 45 and my mission, go to www.energy45.org.